If you find a plugin combination that works great on vocals, guitars, drums, or whatever, you're probably going to want to use those settings again, especially if it's on projects within the same album or EP. That way you can keep the same sound across all of the songs. Now, you could just go in and save the presets into each of those plugins and then bring each of those plugins back up into another project and load up those presets. Now, that takes some time. What we can do in Tracktion Waveform is save all of the plugins with all of the settings into a rack and then quickly load that rack up into another project, and it's going to save you a lot of time, speed up your workflow, and it's very easy to do once we get this set up. So that's what we're going to check out right now. Now on this project, I'm just going to focus on this guitar bus. This is a work in progress song, so there's not a whole lot going on here, but I do have a couple of plugins that I really like on this guitar bus. And you can see it's the REQ or Renaissance EQ from Waves, and also this VEQ or Vintage EQ from Waves. So now let's say I really like this combination and I want to use it across several tracks on an album that I'm working on, or just on singles that I'm working on. I want to quickly load up these settings. Now I'm not going to include this last one here because this is just a send and it's sending to another track, and I might not do that in another project. So I'm not including that, just the two EQs that I have on here. So what I want to do is click on the first one, hold down control on my computer keyboard, click on the second one so they're both highlighted like that, right click on either of them, and then I want to go down to wrap these plugins in a new rack plugin. So here we are in our rack plugin, and it might look a little overwhelming at first, but really it's not. You just have to picture this like it's an actual studio and these are actual hardware units. So with this, we have stereo inputs going to left, and this one's going to the right. And then that's going out from the first EQ into the second EQ here, left and right. And then it's going to our output, which is going to our master track or mix bus. So just picture these lines here as cables in your actual studio, and these are hardware units. You don't really have to worry about this red cable here because that's for MIDI, and we're just working on effects here that don't use MIDI, but it's attached anyway. And if this is what you want, we could just save this by clicking on save, create new preset, and I'm going to call this guitar bus one. Actually, I'll call it guitar bus EQ. There we go. So I'm going to show you how you can also add more effects in here, because if you load it up onto another project, you might need something else in there, like a compressor or maybe some modulation, something else. You can add more effects in here, and I'll show you that in a second. But let's just look at loading this up onto another track. So I'm going to close that down, open another track. Now what we want to do on this new track is you can right click here, add plugin to left, and then you want to go to plugin racks. And you can see here I have a guitar bus wrapper, but that's not the one that I saved. So I want to go to new from preset, and you can scroll down here and you can see guitar bus EQ. That's the one I saved. I'm going to click on that. It loads up our guitar bus wrapper. And there's our two plugins in here. And if we want to change the settings, you just click on the plugins in here and it brings up the user interface for each of the plugins when you click on them. Now, what if on this new track, I want to add a compressor in there? So what we'll do is we can just right click in here, add plugin. And then you can just go through here and find the plugin that you want. If you're using Waveform 12, you can easily search for the plugin. So that's what I'm going to do right now. And I'm going to use CLA 76 stereo, but you can see it's not attached to anything. So how do we attach it to where we want it? Now, first we got to decide where do we want it. I want it at the end, but you could put it in between if you want. And you can see we can move these around, but I want it at the end here. So I'm just going to move this kind of down here so you can see what I'm doing, but you can move this wherever you want. Actually, I'll move it up here. And what we want to do now is just click on this line here. You can see it looks like the full cable is connected to that point right there. So we'll click on this cable. We're going to drag it to the input here, which is the left input. So left out to left input. And then we'll do the same for the right and we'll connect it to the right. Now we need to connect the outputs. So I'll move this back down and we'll click on that node, go left to left, right to right like that. And now we have a compressor plugin in our chain. And there's so many other routing possibilities that you can do with plugin racks. This is just sort of the basic idea. Now, say you wanted to clear all of the wiring, you could easily do that by going to clear all wiring, and that would clear everything if you wanted to start from scratch. Or maybe you want to clear all input wiring. So if we click on that, you can see it clears our inputs and we could do everything ourselves. There are lots of possibilities with this plugin rack. This is just sort of the basics of it to get you started. Now, become a Waveform Pro by clicking the video on the screen to check out even more Waveform tutorials. And if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. For Audio Tech TV, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.